I like peanut butter, but not peanuts. They're too dry. Also, I sweat a lot, unrelated to the peanuts. All right, you guys. So, I'm here with you today to give you a quick makeup tutorial on how to get this very natural look for Pidge Gunderson from Voltron Legendary Defender. So, without too much further ado, let's get into the tutorial. All right, you guys. So, let's get started. The first thing I do is I put my wig caps on. Part of why I do my wig cap first is it keeps the hair out of my face while I go to do all my makeup. But also, I have to fight wig caps a lot because my hair is very slick. So I tend to use a lot of hairspray at conventions or when I need to have my wig cap stay for long periods of time. And I don't like to spray hairspray when I have my makeup all done because I don't want to get hairspray all over that. So I do wig caps first. If you don't have to fight wig caps the way I have to fight wig caps, then you can always do it last. Also to note, I always wear a button-up shirt or a robe or something when I do makeup because I don't like to have to take things over my face as much as I can avoid it. So yeah, it's just a tip. It makes it easier. So let's get started. The first thing that I'm going to use is this Hard Candy color correcting primer. I use the green one because I don't know if you can tell, I have a lot of red in my skin tone, and the green helps to balance that out so I get a more flawless finish. So let's just apply that everywhere. There we go, nice and primed. So then I use an e.l.f. concealer stick to just kind of touch up areas like under my eyes, around my nose, right here, blemishes, anywhere that there's a lot of like extra redness that I want to cover up. I find this e.l.f. concealer is kind of thin, so I put a lot on. And then blend it with a damp beauty brush or beauty sponge. Right, now that's done, we're gonna go ahead and use foundation. So I use the NYX Stay Matte But Not Flat, and this is in a creamy neutral. This tends to go on kind of blotchy to start, so you really have to blend it a lot. Alright, so I put a little on my hand, and then I take Beauty Blender, put some on, and then I just go to town. And then double check in my mirror that everything is looking good. Perfect. I'm really just looking to get kind of a light base down. So we have that. I also use an e.l.f. eye primer for my eyelids. I find it helps just kind of set a nice base. And helps eyeshadow stay on. Alright, so now we're looking a little ghosty. So let's add some contour. I use the e.l.f. contour palette. So it has this great big mirror and it has these four shades. So I find that the darkest shade's a little too dark for me. So I use this shade to do my darker contours. I have a very round face, so I'm gonna focus on cheekbones and under my chin and a little bit on my hairline. And I'm using a contour brush for that. And I'm gonna look in my mirror because it's a little easier. So I'm just following that cheek line to help kind of sharpen the angles of my face. Making fishy faces helps me see where I need the lines to be. And again, you can go as dark as you like and just blend it in. I tend to go kind of light because I'm still getting used to contouring, so. kitchen. This helps define the jawline, and it helps with chubby chins in photos by just kind of hiding it in a shadow. Okay, now that we've done the darks, again, you can see it's pretty light for me. I'm going to move to this lighter tone and do some highlights around there, around the forehead and on the tip of my nose, and a little bit just right here. So I like to just kind of like dab off my brushes, either on my hands or on a towel, just to kind of get some of the other color off before for something lighter. So that's pretty good for our contour. So again, like, you can go heavier, you can go lighter, and kind of depends on what you're feeling, but for Pidge, I keep it pretty natural. She generally has a pretty natural look to her, so. Then I take my e.l.f. blush palette, which, again, has four shades, and I'm gonna go for this kind of, like, browner shade, so I'll use my blush brush. And I just went a little bit on the apples of my cheeks just to kind of like rosy it up just a little, but still kind of natural. All right, now that we have all that set, I'm going to set it all with my NYX No Filter finishing powder. I use a really big brush for that and just powder the whole face. That helps set it, but it also helps kind of final blend everything. If you're going to be at a convention all day, I would suggest also using a finishing spray at this point, just to make sure everything sets completely. I'm not going to do that right now. So at this point, that's my foundation. It's pretty quick. It can take longer if I go heavier on the contour, but that's all we're going to do as a foundation for Pidge, especially since she is very natural, like I said. So I'm going to now move up to my eyes. So I'm going to start with my brows, which I'm not going to do much for it because I have already pretty naturally thick brown eyebrows, and the wig I have is a pretty similar reddish shade, so I don't need to do too much, but we will do some. So start by brushing it out, and then I'm going to be using a brown eyeliner pencil. It's just a really cheap brow pencil, and I'm just going to kind of follow the shape of my eyes, just kind of define it a little more. I'm still pretty new at doing eyebrows, so I keep it pretty light, and I really just follow the shape I already have. What I like about the eyebrow pencil is it generally goes on pretty light, so it looks a lot more natural than some other options. And then we'll do another brush through. You see one side's a little heavier, so I'll just fix it out. There we go. Eyebrows. Okay, so now that the brows are done, that should be pretty quick. I'm going to move on. I am going to do another base, kind of base primer with this NYX Milk pencil, just to kind of like lighten my eyebrow area. It's a nice base too. And then, so I always put my liner on first because I have a really hard time with it and I would rather not mess up all of my pretty eyeshadow. And so for this, I'm going to be using an e.l.f. brown pencil. If you're at a convention all day, I might suggest a brown liquid liner just because it lasts longer. But the pencil also will work. Again, we're going for a very natural look, so I don't want anything that looks really heavy. And because of her red hair and kind of the brown tones of the wig that I have, I'm going to stick with brown. So let's go ahead and put our liner on. I like to hold here to get a more flat surface, but if you can do it without, go for it. And I'm not going to really do any kind of wing on this. I'm keeping it very close to the eye and doing just a little bit on the underside for some definition. I'm not as concerned about having a really thick line with the eyeliner because the eyeshadow will cover some of that, and we'll go back over it at the very end. So that's the eyeliner. Now for eyeshadow, I'm using this Rimmel London palette. It's called English Breakfast, but it has these really pretty kind of like just neutrals, like shimmer kind of tan colors, and we're going to be using all but the darkest shade. So I'm going to use this kind of shimmery taupe as the main eye. Again, this really is just to give a little bit of color. We don't really want an eyeshadowy look, but we want the eyes to still like be visible. I don't know if you can see. It's just a very light shimmer, just enough to kind of give the idea of eyeshadow. So now I'm gonna take this brush, this like thin, smoky eye brush, and I'm going to go for this darker like gray, and we're just gonna put a little bit in the outer corners and crease, just to kind of give a little bit more definition, but still very light, because again, we want the definition, but we don't want it to look very eyeshadowy. And I might go back over with that shimmery like taupe. And now we're going to use the brightest one, and we're gonna basically cover everything. Definitely you wanna focus on right under the eyebrows to just lighten that up. But I'm kind of gonna go over everything just to tone it down and really like neutralize the smokiness of what we just did. Step, I like to go back over with the eyeliner just one more time to get that crisp line back. This is probably why some people do their liner last. I like to do it first because when I go back over it at the end, I have a base that I'm looking at. So there's that part of the eyes. Now we will do mascara. I have really taken to this Miss Manga mascara. I believe it is from Maybelline, but I'm not positive. You can find it though at any drugstore. But I like it because it gives pretty voluminous lashes with very little effort, and it bends, which is kind of nice. And I'm just doing top lashes, and really just enough to like know that there's eyelashes. We don't want really heavy, voluminous lashes for Pidge. And then I end my curve line. Not long, just enough to kind of poke up. So there are our eyes. There you go, eyes. Okay, and so while the eyes I really like, especially because she is going to then be behind glasses, so sometimes you do need heavier eye makeup to really see them outside of the glasses. for me, for Pidge, one of the most important things is how natural her lip is. So I actually have a multi-step process for that. Because I am using cream lipsticks, I have this e.l.f. lip exfoliator. It's basically like salt and like coconut, and it just exfoliates the lips a little. So if you have dry skin, it'll get rid of that, which helps your lipstick stay better. So I like to do that and then take a paper towel and just wipe it down. And it just helps with any dry skin. I like to get a little bit of foundation back on there, because like I said, it does help your lipstick stay better. Then I'm going to use this NYX Natural Lip Liner and line my lips. I like to start at the top. I really like lip liner because it keeps things on your lips better, but also it lets you really set and define your lip shape. Because I have kind of thin, uneven lips. So it lets me kind of even them out. And then just kind of fill it in with the liner. So I know this looks really dark, and this looks very girly. But trust me, it won't stay that way. So then I'm going to use this NYX Lingerie in Lipley, I think. It's number 7. I like this. It's basically going to then foundation my lips back down. It's a liquid. It's a very tan, like my skin tone lipstick. Sometimes I use a clear lip liner. If that were the case, then I would also add on top of that a layer of this NYX matte cream. It's in Stockholm. It's again another really basic lip color, but it has a little bit of a pink tone to it, which can help just kind of like make the lips look a little different from the rest of me. But because I used the natural liner, this already has kind of a pink tint to it, so it helped bring that out and made the lingerie less just my skin tone. But for Pidge, I really like having a very, 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 very neutral lip, but I don't want to go completely lipless for photos and just for dynamics with the wig. So that is the makeup. Now let's see how it looks with our wig. Hey guys, so I have my hoodie on, I've got my wig, let's put it on. I like to make sure my straps are here. And then we add the glasses, which is a very important part of Pidge. When I styled my Pidge wig, I left a lot pretty free because I like how natural it leaves the bangs to look, but it can be a pain in the butt. That's it. There's your Pidge. You've got a very natural look. It still is pretty dynamic. You see, as I get farther away, it still looks really nice. So you can still see all my features defined, but it functions with the color and the shape of the wig and with this sweet collar here. So I hope you enjoyed this quick, dirty makeup tutorial for a natural look for Pidge. If you have any questions, please ask. I'm happy to answer anything. I'm not a makeup expert. I'm still learning a lot, but if I can help or answer, please ask away, let me know. I will put a list of everything I used in the description under this video, so feel free to check that out. And I will catch you guys next time. Bye. Kitty Rose has left the stage.